With all of the uncertainty we see currently, it's common to feel uneasy about investing in the stock market. Market volatility can be difficult to stomach for even seasoned investors. Those without proper savings in place who might be considering jumping into the stock market could be thinking twice. Seeing your retirement savings spike up and down repeatedly is nerve-wracking, more so the older you are. The good news is that when everyone is fearful of the future, it's often a great time to invest. However, there are some funds you can buy that will provide more stability throughout economic unpredictability that will protect your nest egg and help you sleep better at night. These ETFs are great choices for those unsure where they should keep their money. Stay to the end to hear about the ETF that aligns with billionaire Warren Buffett's investing strategy. My name is Chris, and I help teach people about money, personal finance, and investing. If you're interested in improving your financial future, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the like button if this video is helpful. SPHD. SPHD is Invesco's S&P 500 High Dividend ETF, which has selected 50 of the highest yielding, least volatile stocks held in the benchmark offered at an expense ratio of 0.3%. Real estate is this fund's largest sector allocation, known for providing higher than average dividends, followed by financials, utilities, and energy. Some of the largest holdings consist of Kimco Realty, Altria, Philip Morris, and Western Union. The dividend yield is currently over 5%, which makes it a great income fund that will continue to grow your account even as stock prices drop. Payments are made on a monthly basis, which allows your dividends to become reinvested sooner and ultimately compound faster, which will contrast with the slightly higher expense ratio. This fund is an excellent, well-rounded product for those seeking income and a combination of diversification and stability. SPYD. SPYD is another S&P 500 high dividend fund offered by SPDR. Made up of around 80 different companies, this fund is heavily invested in real estate in addition to the consumer discretionary sector, which provides much more volatility than the previously mentioned SPHD. Although, the hefty dividend payments will provide steady income for your portfolio, regardless of market volatility, and if the market drops significantly, it can be a great opportunity to purchase this fund at more of a discount than the low volatility alternatives. Many of these other more stable funds are hard to buy on sale during a substantial market dip, as their prices, more often than not, remain stable. Among the fund's top holdings are Leggett & Platt, AbbVie, Western Union, and AT&T, with its largest sector allocations being financials, consumer non-cyclicals, consumer cyclicals, and energy. The dividend yield is currently over 6%, and the expense ratio is just 0.07%. VDC. Vanguard Consumer Staples is a great choice during unsure times because the 93 stocks held are non-discretionary. This means the holdings provide items that people under most circumstances must purchase. Consumer staple companies include those such as Procter & Gamble, which makes laundry detergent, dish soap, toilet paper, and related items, Philip Morris and Altria, which sell tobacco products, and Walmart and Pepsi. These companies all do very well when times are tight because people are staying home and consuming more household products, purchasing food and buying less expensive clothing instead of eating out and buying high-end attire. Consumer staples companies are known to perform better when the overall market lags. The dividend yield is just over 2.6%, and the expense ratio is 0.1%. VOO. As always, it's nearly impossible to go wrong with an S&P 500 ETF. VOO is a Vanguard product that holds the 500 large companies held within the S&P 500 across many different sectors, providing broad market diversification for almost foolproof investing. Since the S&P 500 is generally referred to as the market, you will experience average amounts of price swings, but you should be able to sleep well knowing that each holding has met the financial health and size requirements in order to be selected for this fund. Since Microsoft, Apple, and Amazon are the top three largest holdings, it makes sense that technology is the largest sector held, followed by healthcare and financials. The dividend yield is around 2%, and the expense ratio is just 0.03%. If you're looking for the easiest way to invest without having to worry if you made the right decision, this is a perfect choice. VHT. VHT is a Vanguard fund made up of entirely healthcare stocks. This means companies that provide healthcare products, medications, services, technology, and equipment. The three largest holdings consist of Johnson & Johnson, United Health Group, and Pfizer. Currently, there are 397 companies held in this fund, with an expense ratio of 0.1%. The dividend yield is approximately 2%, which will provide a modest amount of stable income. People get sick regardless of economic cycles, so adding this to your portfolio will hedge against market volatility. They still need to take medications, have surgeries, they still get injured, and so on. While healthcare is always in demand, higher risk can be attributed to the volatility associated with pharmaceutical and healthcare companies, particularly if it's a prominent political discussion during an election year. VFMV. The Vanguard U.S. Minimum Volatility Fund is comprised of about 200 stocks that are likely to be less volatile and less subject to market extreme highs and lows. This fund is designed to hedge against extreme ups and downs by holding companies with steady income regardless of the economy. Included in the top holdings are McDonald's and Hershey Company, which have been known to fare well during market corrections and recessions. Consumer staples makes up a large percentage of the fund, which is no surprise, as they're quite the opposite of consumer cyclical stocks, which are subject to extreme price fluctuations as consumer behaviors rapidly shift. Shareholders will receive close to a 3% dividend, which adds to the desirability for older investors. The expense ratio is 0.13%. VTV. Lastly, the Vanguard Value ETF holds over 300 value stocks. Value stocks include those that are trading at a lower price relative to their fundamentals, such as dividends, earnings, and sales, which makes it extra appealing for investors with longer time horizons. In other words, value stocks are cheap in relation to their financial measures. This could be due to the fact that the stock price has been beaten down to a low price, or that the stock's price hasn't caught up with its rise in financial health. Value investing is a strategy that Warren Buffett has used to amass his nearly $80 billion net worth. Furthermore, value stocks are more stable than their peers, as you're essentially buying financially sound companies for very low prices. Value investing is quite the opposite of growth investing, which usually entails purchasing companies with debatably reasonable valuations. The top 10 holdings include Johnson & Johnson, J.P. Morgan Chase, and Procter & Gamble. Financials and healthcare make up a large percentage of this fund, many of which can be found in Buffett's own portfolio. The dividend yield is healthy at around 3%, and the expense ratio is very low at just 0.04%. While these are some great choices to hedge against extreme price swings in the stock market, remember that discounted prices are also less common, due to their stable nature. In other words, some price swings are healthy for investors who dollar-cost average and invest consistently and without emotion. When experts are claiming the stock market is either overvalued or prices are depressed and may never recover, you can almost always be sure that these ETFs will be good, secure choices over the long term. Their stability will also help you keep your cool when the overall stock market plunges 40%. It can be beneficial emotionally to see your positions hold steady, even if you know that your investments are likely to recover eventually. Begin adding these ETFs to your portfolio to hedge against those wild price fluctuations.